Morning, friends. In the previous session, we already discussed different types of flat wind drives. The continuation of this is the determination of velocity ratio in the belt drive. Next one is length of the belt drive. Length of open belt drive. First, we'll see length of open belt drive. Later on, we'll move on to the length of belt in the cross belt drive. Right, so this also we have already discussed. The open belt drive is used to transmit power from one shaft to another shaft when both the shafts are rotating in the same direction. Okay, so let us take a driver of diameter D1 or the radius is R1. Similarly, driven member or this follower is of diameter D2 or R2. So radius is R2. Let us say the power is transmitted from driven member to driving member to driven member. So this is right. So this is driving pulley and this is driven pulley or this is follower, right? And the belt is placed over the circumference of these pulleys. Now we need to find out length of this belt. So this length of the belt is to be calculated. Now this is a driving member. So the center of this pulley is denoted as O1. Center of this pulley is denoted as O2. Right? And the distance between these two shafts is denoted as small x. Distance between the shafts is denoted as small x. Right, then the radius of driving pulley, the diameter of driving pulley is denoted as D1, hence the radius is R1, and radius of driven pulley is R2. Okay, then so the belt is placed over driving and driven pulleys, right? So the angle of wrap of this belt over the larger pulley is definitely greater than 180 degrees. That angle of wrap, so you will get the wrapping angle is greater than 180 degrees in the case of the driving pulley, right? So this is 180 and here there is an angle alpha. So this is alpha angle, and on the other side also there is an angle alpha. So and here the corresponding angle alpha denoted in the smaller pulley like this. Obviously the angle of wrap on the smaller pulley is 180 minus 2 alpha. So here this is theta, right? So theta is equal to 180 minus 2 alpha here, and here theta is equal to 180 plus 2 alpha, right? So this theta plays a vital role in determining the power transmission, right? The power transmission is highly affected by theta 2 value, 180 minus 2 alpha. So this value should be higher so that you will get a higher value of power transmission. Okay, so now here you need to find out this length of the belt. That's why the belt length is split into number of segments, right? So this is denoted with the E, and this point is denoted with the F, and this point is denoted with the G, and this point is denoted with H. Okay, and the extreme left side diameter point on the driving pulley is denoted with J, and the extreme right side diameter point on the driven member is denoted with K here. Okay, let us assume that the power is transmitted from driving member to driven member, and the pulleys are rotating in the clockwise direction, both the driving and the driven pulleys. Okay, now what are the O1 and O2? O1, O2 are the centers. O1 comma O2 are centers of both the driver and driven members. Then R1 comma R2 are radii of driving and driver and driven members. Okay, then X is distance between the centers of shafts, center distance. Between shafts. Okay, then L is length of the belt. Length. L be the length of the belt. This is what you need to find out. L value you have to calculate. So this total L is the length of the belt is split into number of segments, right? EF, then FH, then HG, HG to this GE, right? So, and this is this contact surface is symmetric about this horizontal axis. This contact surface is also symmetric about this horizontal axis. So that's why this GE can be split into two segments, two equal segments, GJ and JE. Similarly, FK and KH. Okay, so therefore, length of the belt. Length of the belt L is equal to G arc G J E arc GJE plus EF plus R FKH plus HD. Okay, so this we can simplify further. GJE. So this is GJE. So this contact surface is symmetric about this horizontal axis. This is the axis here. That's why you can rewrite this as 2 into R J. you can write 2JE plus EF plus 2 into RFK. Plus HG. Okay, but HG is equal to EF. This HG is equal to EF. Okay, so that's why HG can be replaced with EF once again. So this is EF. Therefore, you can rewrite this as 2 into JE plus EF plus RK. These two are the arc lengths and EF is like this. Okay, now you can find out these values from this figure. Okay, so that you will get total length of the belt. Okay, so this is alpha, is it right? This is alpha, this is also alpha, this is also alpha, this is also alpha. So here you draw a line from point F. You draw a line from point O2 onto the line O1E, right? And this line must be parallel to draw a line from O2 onto the line O1E and mark this point as M. Okay, so this line must be parallel to this. This line must be parallel to this. Obviously, if this angle is alpha, right, this angle also equal to alpha, since it is, right, these two are parallel, right? So now this length is equal to this length. This length is equal to this length. What is this value? O1E is equal to R1 and O2F is equal to R2. Then O1M is equal to R1 minus R2. R1 minus R2. So from this, from triangle O1, O2, M, sine alpha is equal to O1M divided by O1 O2. So this O1M can be expressed as I said, O1E minus ME. Yeah. Divided by O1 O2. Okay. What is O1E here? O1E is R1 minus R2 divided by O1 O2 is X. O1 O2 is X. Okay. So now from this, you can find out the value of alpha. Since the angle alpha is very, very small, therefore, instead of taking sine alpha, you can take alpha is smaller, so sine alpha can be expressed as alpha that is equal to R1 minus R2 divided by X. Okay, so now from this you can find out this arc values. What is arc value here? this org, what is EJG or JGE is equal to 5 plus 2 alpha, or JE is equal to 5 by 2 plus alpha, 5 by 2 plus alpha, whereas FK is equal to 5 by 2 minus alpha, 5 by 2 minus alpha, right? So, org JE is equal to 5 by 2 plus alpha into R1. Therefore, R1. Okay. Similarly, RFK is equal to 5/2 minus alpha into FK is on the given number, so given number radius is R2, so 5/2 minus alpha. Okay, and similarly, you can find out EF value. EF is equal to, EF means this value EF is equal to O to M. O to M is equal to, so this is triangle O1, O to M, right? O to M is equal to, right? So this square, O1, O2 square minus O1 M square. Okay. So F is equal to, F is equal to O to M. That's equal to square root of O1, O2 square minus O1 M square. That is equal to, what is O1, O2 value? O1, O2 value. O1, O2 is X. Okay. So, X square minus O1 M is equal to difference of radius. R1 minus R2 whole square. So this is O2M value. Okay. So simply you can bring this x to the outside. It is x square. You bring x to the outside. Then 1 minus R1 minus R2 divided by x. Then what is R1 minus R2 here? R1 minus R2 by X? It is sin alpha. It is sin alpha. So that is equal to EF is equal to X into square root of 1 minus alpha square, or 1 minus sin alpha square. So that is equal to 1 minus alpha square. Okay. Now you can substitute all these values. You know the value of arc JE here, arc FK here, and you know the value of EF. You just substitute here, then find out the values of all these parameters. So this equation here. So from this equation, you can rewrite this as x into 1 minus R1 minus R2 by x whole square whole to the power of 1 by 2 whole to the power of 1 by 2. 1 by 2 is the root of this value. Now, this is just like a binomial function, or by using binomial theorem, you can expand this equation so that you will get this value as x into R1 minus R2 divided by so from the binomial expansion you will get the x minus R1 minus R2 whole square by 2x. Okay, this is equal to EF value. Okay, now you have EF value and you have this J or J value, FK value and EF value. Now you just substitute in this equation. So length of the belt L is equal to 2 into 5 by 2 plus R5 into R1 plus X minus of R1 minus R2 whole square by 2X plus 5 by 2 minus alpha into R2. Okay, now you can simplify this. Now, finally, after simplification, you will get 5 into R1 plus R2. R1 plus R2 plus 2x plus R1 minus R2 whole square by 2x. So this is length of the belt in the case of open belt. 5 into R1 plus R2 plus 2x right, plus R1 minus R2 squared by x. So you can easily remember this, right? So this is pi R1, half of the circumference. Full circumference is pi D1, half of the circumference is pi R1, and here half of the circumference is pi R2, pi R1 plus pi R2, and 2 into length 2x, right? 2x. And to consider the excess lengths here in these two cases and reduce the lengths in these two cases, you can consider this extra term R1 minus R2 whole square divided by x. Okay, so that's how you can find out the value of length of the belt in open belt drive. Okay, so similarly, in a similar fashion, you can find out length of the belt in the cross belt drive also.